earlier. But mine just got accepted to MIT.
MIT? Isn't that the best school in the world?
Well, for science, it probably is.
How did you get in? Can you teach me?
Well, you do seem pretty bright to me. Do you love science?
I love science.
You know, there's a meteor shower tonight. You want to go?
I'd love to. Mom, can I?
Of course, you can't be wrong hanging around Uncle Mike. Tell him how to be as smart as you are. Maybe one day you can both be on the moon. Now, you can ask Uncle Mike all your questions. I'll pack some snacks. And maybe you'll catch a falling star when you walk with Uncle Mike.
All right, let's do it. Come on, you gotta keep up. Come on, bud.
I'm trying. Wait. It's a small step for Uncle Mike, but a giant leap for Nick.
Yes, Mom?
You got this letter.
Purdue? Did I get in?
Well, they said yes, but they got it all wrong. It must be a typo or something. They said your major is biology.
So they accepted me.
Did you really pick biology? Does your dad know about this?
No, but I thought he'd be happy if I was a doctor like him.
Are you out of your mind? A hospital's no place for a girl like you. You don't have your daddy's brains.
I could be a nurse too.
No respectable man is gonna want a nurse for his wife. A nurse is like a maid dressed in white.
But I love science.
Who cares what you love? You need to focus your priorities on getting a husband that loves you. Forget the nonsense of biology. You need to take home economics. I'll let you go to Purdue for that.
But...
And seriously, you need to think about your weight. When I was your age, I was half your size. Your butt's as big as Idaho. No boy at Purdue is even gonna look at you the way you look right now.
Mom!
No, listen to me. I'm your mother. I'm telling you the truth. You need to lose weight and pay attention. You'll be happy one day that I told it like it is.
I will go to Purdue, but my mom, she wants me to major in home economics.
Home economics? You have to go to school for that? I thought you wanted to be a doctor, just like your dad.
Yeah, I do, but... You know how my mom is. She'll just fight with me over it.
Why don't you ask your dad? He'd support you.
My dad, he's always busy and he doesn't want to fight with my mom. I envy you. You could go for your passions.
I'm so happy that I'm going to be a scientist one day. I want to design an airplane. And maybe even a rocket. I want to do so many great things. So, what do you want to do?
My mom, she just wants me to find a good husband and use my home economic skills.
It has.
You're so glad now you can come here and not worry about your mom.
Oh my gosh, I'm so relieved.
I'm relieved for you.
I know, right?
Have you thought about what fraternity you want to join? I hear that's the best part of college. You make all kinds of friends.
Oh my goodness.
What's wrong? Is your mom here?
No, who is that?
That's Joan. She's the prettiest Alpha Omega girl.
No. The guy she's with.
Oh, that's Nick. He's a pilot, a war hero. His plane was caught in a bombing, and he flew back with only one wing. He got 2 gold stars, and he's the chairman of the Purdue Aero Flying Club. He's also the baritone player in the marching band.
Really? I don't know what it is, but there's just something about him. He seems like the one for me.
Why would he want you when he has Joan?
I don't know, but just something tells me he's gonna be mine. How can I meet him? I'll join a fraternity.
Want to join the Delta Theta Fraternity, the Flying Club, and the Marching Band?
All of them.
Well, how are you going to do that? Look at her. Do you think he would want you?
I'll make it happen.
Well, you have a lot to do. You really want Nick?
Yes.
It's gonna take a lot of work.
Okay, whatever it takes. Oh, wow. This is beautiful.
My mom made this dress.
Yeah?
I need to lose some weight. And this will show your butt.
Do you think I could get this to fit me?
It's gonna take a lot of work.
Oh my gosh. This is gorgeous, but it's so small.
That's why you're gonna have to work to lose some weight to fit into it.
Well,
the Flying Club's gonna have a swimming party in 2 weeks. And when Nick sees you in this, he could be yours.
Okay, whatever it takes to win his heart. Can we do this?
I think we can.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
dance a little bit. And then move yourself towards the mirror and touch the mirror with your butt very lightly.
With my butt? How, what do you mean?
It's okay, okay, just don't do it, okay then. Just be really cute and then walk out of the frame. Cute, okay?
Okay, right.
Turn around again, and kind of dance a little bit, and then move yourself towards the mirror and touch the mirror with your butt very lightly.
With my butt? How, what do you mean?
It's okay, okay, just don't do it, okay then. Just be really cute and then walk out of the frame.
I'm not gonna want you to be on your butt. Do you really want Nick?
Yes.
It's gonna take a lot of work.
Okay, whatever it takes. Oh, wow. This is beautiful.
My mom made this dress.
Yeah?
Let's see. I need to lose some weight. And this will show your butt.
Do you think I could get this to fit me?
It's gonna take a lot of work.
Oh my gosh. This is gorgeous, but it's so small.
That's why you're gonna have to work to lose some weight to fit into it.
Well,
the Flying Club's gonna have a swimming party in 2 weeks. And when Nick sees you in this, he could be yours.
Okay. Whatever it takes to win his heart.
Mm-hmm.
Can we do this?
I think we can.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Let's sip it. And then give me the twirl. That was cute. There you go. And you're excited, you're going to the dance, all that stuff. All right. And one more twirl, and then out. Yep.
Okay.
All right. And action.
something happened today at work.
You mean when you flew?
Yes.
What happened?
The engines failed.
You mean your engines? But you're okay.
We were at 30,000 feet when one engine failed. Plane started spinning. I had to cut one of the engines to stop the torque. I could not believe we made it back on one engine.
I know you're a test pilot, but if that means you have to fly these unsafe planes, I'd rather live on food stamps. We can't lose you.
At the time, I thought I was going to die. I thought I was going to see Vivi in heaven. You know, I miss her so much.
Vivi is with God. We need you here.
I know. I'm here. Did I tell you that my plane was shot in Korea?
No, you never did.
My wing was damaged on a bombing run. 6 feet of my wing was cut off. Planes were hit and I saw them die. When I was hit, I was proud to die for my country. For freedom. And the plane was spinning and I saw a golden light in the sky and I thought this was God's calling. Flew with me back because I only had one wing. When I first saw you, I saw the light reflecting from your hair. I thought you were the angel.
I don't know if I'm your angel, but I will always be here. Plane was not your fault. It was a bad plane. You are the greatest. I love you. Vivi, you can't leave her at the hospital.
Where's Mike?
He's in bed. Is Vivi okay?
Vivi's okay. She is with God.
What?
Vivi's gone.
No. No. See her.
didn't suffer much.
Mike is starting school this week.
Great.
I'm thinking of getting a part-time job.
Why?
I thought we could, you know, just get a little bit of money for Mike's college. He's starting college soon.
What can you do?
I thought with my home economics degree, maybe I could get something. I could work at Dr. Jones part-time and pick Mike up after school.
Are we having money problems?
No. No, 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 no. I just want change. I don't want to stay home and watch TV. I want to be free. You could go up 10,000 feet and be free. And I have no place to go.
Just because you can fly 10,000 feet does not mean you're free.
Well, at least you're not useless.
Please don't say that.
I am useless. I didn't finish school. I'm a bad cook. I'm a bad mother.
You are not.
I didn't protect Phoebe. Could have taken her to the doctor. Could have done something.
doctor said nothing would help. She's gone, and we must accept that.
I can't accept that. I want my baby back.
Have an interview at NASA.
NASA? Isn't that dangerous?
I mean, dangerous than being a test pilot. I got an interview notice, and if I get the job, you and Mike will have the best insurance. And you get a chance to go back to college and finish your degree.
Thank you for doing that for us.
You're welcome.
I just don't... I mean, we have so many perfect applicants. I mean, I don't understand.
I mean, you don't understand why we have so many applicants?
No, I'm not questioning your judgment. It's just that, I mean, we have so many perfect applicants. I mean, why choose a guy who's crashed so many planes?
Well, there's no such thing as a perfect applicant. These people have told half the story. This mission is going to be something that's never been attempted before. He's going to tell the other half of the story. He's going to make history.
But this guy, the one you picked, he's got a bachelor's degree. Whereas these applicants all have master's degrees or even their doctorates.
We're not teaching history here, we're making history. You know, a degree doesn't mean a thing in space.
Okay, granted. But why him? I mean, his bomber plane in Korea, it was shot down. Okay? After the war, he flew his college's, you know, flight club plane, and that crashed also.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then, as a test pilot, just 2 years ago he crashed another plane, and this is the guy we pick.
Well, he survived all those crashes, didn't he? He's looked death in the face many times and walked away. Besides, he looks great in a uniform.
I mean, if it's the look you want, then why not just hire some Hollywood star?
Well, there's not really any Hollywood star that has his smile. Besides, he's an actor already. In college, he was in two plays, and he wrote some plays. You know, I think he's perfect for second team.
Wait. Are you talking about the backup plan?
Yeah, the backup plan.
Okay, so this guy probably won't even ever take off. Okay, got you. But, I mean, can you trust him?
Yes. He almost gave his life in Korea. You know, okay, I'll talk to him before we choose him for second team. There's also a lot of PhDs I've already chosen for second team. I have a gut feeling about this guy. Just trust me. Mr. Strong, thank you for sharing that with us. Now, I just have one more question. This is a very, very dangerous mission. Why are you willing to accept the challenge?
I had a daughter. 3 years old. Sweetest girl in the world. She died 3 months ago. Brain tumor. I don't know why God took her. I know God has a plan for everyone. And I believe my plan is to serve my country. I've survived plane crashes more than once. I don't know why God picked me. But I believe I must answer the call.
Okay, now the written test you just took, do you remember the last question?
Yes.
Okay, do you remember your answer?
Yes. The one about our loved ones?
Mm-hmm.
I thought it may be a trick question to test our integrity, but after I saw the question, what would you do to save your loved ones? I recalled that I would have done more to save my little girl. She just died in my arms. I would have done anything to save her.
Okay, so you gave a very honest answer.
Yes, sir.
Okay, there's no doubt the value of your love for your family. The bigger question is, would you do anything for your country?
Of course. I love them. I love my country even more, and that's why I'm here today. I love my family with all my heart, but my duty is to serve my country.
Excellent. Mr. Strong, you'll be hearing from us. Thank you.
Yes, they accepted me.
Wow, that's so great. Why didn't you tell me earlier? Mike will be thrilled.
I want to. I just wanted to make sure that you're okay with it.
Of course. I'll be so proud of you. We will both be so proud of you.
And we have to move again, so...
I will be happy to go where no woman has gone before, as long as I'm with you.
Mr. Strong. After the loss of Apollo 1, top management is deciding they might possibly put a pause on the entire mission. Now, I know the burden is squarely on your team and on your shoulders.
We're very sorry for the loss of our friends. But we know the dangers when we sign up. If it's ready to go, we'll go. If we need to wait, we will wait.
Well, technically, we probably should wait. But politically, that's not an option. Remember, President Kennedy made a promise to America that we would land on the moon by 1969. If we don't keep his promise he made before he died, the Soviet Union will laugh at us. In fact, the whole world will laugh at us. That is not an option. We must land on the moon.
I know, and if I have to give my life to make it happen, I will.
Well, my goal is to launch this rocket. It's not to see you blow up in it.
I want to be the first American to land, not the fourth American to die trying.
Okay, so you will do whatever it takes to make this, right?
You have my words.
Good, Mr. Strong.
Look at you. What are you now? Vice president?
Actually, I just started my own company.
I'm so proud of you, girl power.
I'm so proud of you. Look at your husband. He's gonna be in a history book. He's everyone's hero. And you're a mother. I'm still 2,000 films away from finding my man.
But I'm just his wife. I haven't accomplished anything.
Some men land on the moon.
The driving force is their wives.
Yeah, but he's changed. It's like ever since his mission, he's been cold like a rock. He doesn't share his stories. He's often quiet. I don't know what happened.